Hello, I'm Indy, and welcome to this first part in the bonus series for the Daikatana playthrough. I thought it would be a fun idea to play quickly through the Nintendo 64 version of the game and quickly compare it with the PC version. That's the regular playthrough on the channel. There will be a lot of editing going on during the cutscenes because they're even longer than the PC version and there's no speech, so they're even more boring. Let's go. Well, the format changed somewhat from widescreen. Yeah, it does it again. Not sure what's going on there. This looks pretty similar. The training is different. Okay, he looks a little bit more colorful. He talks in pink as well. Apparently we're telling the story with art this time instead of moving cutscenes. Oh, that's cool. You actually see Mishima's goons coming. I like that. Well, at least you see how they are gonna approach them. Even though it looks pretty terrible. That's cool as well. Oh, she's hideous looking in that hologram. Yes, look at her very closely. Red stripes mean it's serious. Oh, he's actually gonna do something in this one? Wow! Whoops. Now he's just showing off. He actually got them. The end result is still the same, though. Whoop, there we go. Right into the marsh. Okay, we landed in the marsh as well. And yeah, this looks hideous, I know. And it looks even worse originally. But this is emulated. So it's a little bit on a... higher resolution and a higher frame rate, I think. Okay, how do we switch weapons? There we go. Yeah, and as you can see, it's a lot more tech-based than its than nature-based as in the PC version. Also, the first part of this, the first episode, has four episodes instead of the 7 of the PC version. And we immediately leveled up here after 3 enemies, or even after 2, I'm not sure. And we can choose which ones. Man, that's a tough one. I've got to destroy the power supply. Okay, they actually learn you this one. There we go. Right from the start. Yeah, this is not a good game, guys. Well, never mind then. You know, if people think about Daikatana, a lot of people think about this version of the game, because JonTron did a very famous video on it on YouTube. And people don't realize it's the N64 version, or that the PC version is actually a lot different. So they actually think this is Daikatana. Okay. Yeah, this is very slow, very actually terrible. It doesn't play well, and it's nothing like the PC version. You will recognize a couple of things, but yeah. Okay, ducking, that's where JonTron got stuck, is weird. There's a select button. I'm not sure which one it is. And if you press that button and jump at the same time, you can actually duck. It's really weird. And we leveled up again. Yeah. This is a train wreck. Although I have to say, the game, just as in the PC version, gets better the farther you get. But the difficulty is practically non-existent in this game either. Especially not when it comes to combat. Actually, it was a secret there, but it's also a skill power-up. As you can see, you didn't miss much. And yeah, most enemies die with one hit, and it actually doesn't matter which weapon you use, so that's weird as well. Yeah, this is that area in the PC game where we had to jump on top of the thing to open the door. So yeah, naturally, the first time I played this, I went up here, but there's actually nothing there. We can't go any further until we open this door. And this one, we just press the switch. We do get the Mishima guards a lot faster than in the main game, though. Because here we were still fighting the frogs and the mosquitoes. Okay, nothing here. No turret. This part does resemble the PC game a little bit, though. It's funny because I read an entire preview of this in the N64 magazine, and I know that they were saying, yeah, we know the PC version isn't well received, but we just got the blueprints of the PC version and we did make our own game, and it's gonna be so much better than the PC version. That's actually funny looking back at it. I think for the next episode of the bonus video, that's bonus video 3, I will try to dig up that magazine. And yeah, believe it or not, that was actually already the Marsh level. That's ridiculous. The cutscene itself took almost 15 minutes, and this maybe 3. Weird. Let's see if we get the ghost of our ancestor here as well. Oh, there he is. He looks different. He doesn't have a beard and anything. Oh, he kind of does. Not the same, though. His hair is also way different. Not sure if he's having hair or if it's a weird hat. I'm very slowly breaking the console. I think it's off to the sewer system, right? Although I think the sewer system is cut in this game. If I'm not mistaken, there are 4 levels, so 3 of the levels compared to the PC version are cut. And sewer system is definitely cut. I think crematorium and processing as well. This area looks exactly the same. Got the sidewinder. Wow, he takes a lot of sidewinder shots. Alright, just as I said that they all take one shot no matter what, we get an enemy that actually takes a lot of shots. Also, we cannot kill the workers in this version. Hey, there is a secret under here as well. Interesting. So they kept a couple of things exactly the same. Not exactly, but you know what I mean. There's no room with guards in it though. Jeez. You walk so slow if you are used to the PC version. Or you run, so I'm actually running right now. There's a button to switch between running and walking. Okay. Gonna have to go under here as well. Now this is all pretty much the same. We did release the prisoners as well, but I don't think we can kill them. Nope. I don't think Nintendo allowed that. Okay, no side area here, just the elevator with enemies. You have to fight enemies on the way. There seem to be a gun here. Oh, we got the shot cycler. We actually needed to come up here. Oh, that opened up that thing over there. We got some skill powers ups on these ledges though, but we really, really don't need them. Okay, there we go. Weirdly enough, this almost feels like we're getting very quickly through solitary as well. And we keep leveling up. Okay, it does seem it's gonna have overall the same structure though. We start off low here and then we have to go up there. See if we can get rid of him already. There we go. And we do have an area that down as well. Ah, I do think this looks cooler than the PC version. These guys here, what they're doing the weird experiments on, I do like that a lot. Okay. Is there a way to get on top of the control booth? Just looking if there are secrets in the same spots. You can go up there, but there is no ladder. Oh, the bridge is actually disappearing again. We leveled up once again. Okay, overall this map, at least parts of this map, because a lot of parts are cut as well, but it does seem to get the structure, the main structure right, as it seems. That's very reminiscent as well. Yep, works exactly the same. Anything below? No. Okay, this is the same area as well. No secret down there though. And a keycard behind the logo here as well, so that's all the same. But it plays so poorly, guys. It plays really, really poorly. What's this weird looking crate though? That's weird, that doesn't seem to fit at all. Okay, at least this map seems to be a little bit bigger than the marsh one. Okay. This is the area I think where we will encounter Superfly, but this looks pretty different, almost mirrored, but with an extra side area. It's not where Superfly is. Okay, so the Sidewinder is completely useless compared to the other weapons. It is the same area though. He's nowhere to be found though. But it leads into this same meat grinding area. Yeah, it does. That's so weird. He's just hitting at air. Oh, here is Superfly. How about some information, pal? Speak. Yeah, that's somewhat to say. Yeah, that's somewhat the same text as in the PC game. The killing kind, yeah. And that's the end of Solitary. Wow. They do mention the crematorium, but I'm pretty sure it's cut out. But we'll all have to see this for the next video, because I'm gonna end this one here. I think we've seen enough crap for one video. Yeah, Head Security Chief Superfly Johnson. Although I do like the comparison. I do like that if you like the PC version and then this, you play this one, you see the similarities, but you can't understand how terrible the Nintendo 64 turned out to be. Even if you don't like the PC version, you can see there's a huge difference in quality here between the two. So I do hope that you like this little bonus videos as well. And if you do, leave a like and comment and subscribe. And I will see you next time. Goodbye. Whoa, he's punching right through the wall. That was cool.